students, we have finished with physical and gross examination and chemical examination. Now we move to microscopic examination. Microscopic examination. The semen sample is processed for examination under microscope. Here we look for motility of sperm, sperm count, sperm morphology, agglutination of spermatozoa and some other findings present in the semen. Sperm motility. First we will learn about sperm motility. For examination of motility of sperm, we must make a wet preparation. Mix the sample well. Remove small volume of semen immediately after mixing. Place a small volume, that is 10 microliter of liquefied semen on a glass slide and cover it with a 22x22mm glass cover slip. Wait for the sample to stop drifting, that is it takes 60 seconds, then assess the slide. Here you will have to note that if number of spermatozoa per visual field varies considerably, then the sample is not homogeneous. In such cases, the sample should be mixed again thoroughly and a new slide prepared as above. Now, examine the preparation under high power objective with reduced illumination. Here you will have to note that as the motility and velocity of the spermatozoa is dependent on temperature, assessment of motility is performed using a microscope with the warm stage. How to assess motility? Where to look for? 5 mm away from the edge of the cover slip is seen. This is to prevent the observation of effects of drying on motility, because the counting takes longer time and drying will take place. That's why 5 mm away from the edges. Systematically scan the slide to avoid repeatedly viewing the same area. Change fields often and randomly. Start scoring a given field at a random instant. Do not wait for the spermatozoa to swim into the field to begin scoring. Assess the motility of all the spermatozoa within a defined area of the field. First count progressive slide, next count non-progressive progressive cells, next count non-progressive cells, and finally immotile spermatozoa cells. With experience, it may be possible to score all the categories of the sperm movement at one time. Aid to assessing sperm motility. An eyepiece reticle makes it easier to count motile and immotile spermatozoa. What is eyepiece reticle? Reticle eyepiece means it is a small piece of glass with ruler or grid, as you can see in this slide, imposed on it, that fits into the microscope eyepiece. When looking through the microscope, the reticle image is imposed upon your specimen image. Most often the reticle is used to make measurements or count the particles. This is reticle eyepiece. Now, next, systematic selection of the field for assessment of sperm motility at least 5 mm from the edge of the cover slip is done. Motility and progression can be assessed in the following manner. Motility refers to the percentage of moving sperm in the raw ejaculate. Samples are considered normal if they have greater than 40% motility. Progression. Progression refers to the forward movement of the sperm and is recorded as in different grades. Grade 4, grade 3, grade 2, grade 1 and grade 0. We will see what are these grades. Grade 4, fast and forward progression where sperm moves in a straight direction. Grade 3, sperm moves forward but at a slower speed and or in a curved direction. Grade 2, sperm moves slowly and in a poorly defined direction. Grade 1, sperm moves but fails to progress forward. Grade 0, sperm shows no signs of movement. Expressed as percentage, the number of sperms belonging to each grade. Normally, at the end of 1 hour, the individual should have more than 25% of sperms belonging to grade 4 and or grade 3, more than 50% of sperm belonging to grade 2, 3 or grade 4. The sperm motility is recorded at the end of 2 hours, 3 hours and 6 hours. Ensure that preparation does not dry by keeping the slide on a wet filter paper under a petri dish. This provides a moist environment to the wet preparation and does not allow drying. The number of fertile sperms decreases by 5% per hour after the 4th hour of collection. If the motility is less than 50%, a vitality test is done. Vital staining of the spermatozoa allows quantification of the fraction of living cells independently of their motility. Live and dead sperm are distinguished. We'll see to this vitality test in the later slides. Poor sperm motility, or it is also called as asthenozoospermia, is diagnosed when less than 32% of the sperm are able to move effectively. Causes for asthenozoospermia are abnormal spermatogenesis, abnormal maturation of the sperm in the epididymis, abnormalities in the transportation, varicocele means enlargement of veins within the scrotum. Next, necrospermia, or it is also called as necrozoospermia. It is a condition in which there is a low percentage of live and very much a percentage of immotile spermatozoa in this semen. It can be diagnosed via a semen analysis with the vitality staining performed to determine whether the sperms are dead or alive or immotile. Factors affecting sperm density or motility. Now, these are some of the habitual factors like high intake of soya. This decreases sperm density. High consumption of tobacco decreases sperm density and motility. Consumption of cocaine or marijuana decreases sperm motility. Vaginal lubricants, if used, it decreases sperm motility. Alcoholism affects all semen parameters. That is, if you consume alcohol, it affects all the semen parameters. Sperm vitality. In my slide number 35, I have told that motility less than 50%, vitality test is done. Now we will see about the sperm vitality or viability. Vitality means capacity to live and develop. Viability means ability to live or succeed. If the percent of motile cell is low, then this is mandatory. It is estimated by assessing the membrane integrity of the cell. It is assessed after liquefaction at 30 minutes. It can be done routinely on all these samples. So, sperm vitality is said to be normal if 58% of cells are alive. high percentage of immotile and normally more than or equal to 58% of cells are in the living forms. High percentage of immotile and non-viable cells leads to necrozoospermia. That is, it may indicate epididymal pathology. Immotile live sperms leads to immotile cilia syndrome, that is structural defect in the flagellum. There are two methods of vitality testing. The dye exclusion method using eosin nigrosin. This is the most commonly used method. The principle says that damaged plasma membrane of non-vital, that is dead cells, allow entry of membrane impairment stains. That is, if the cell is dead, it will allow the stain to enter the cell. Hypoosmotic swelling test, HOS, it is an alternative method. The principle states that only cells with intact membranes, that is alive cells, will swell in hypotonic solution. So these are the two methods. We will see one of the method here. Vitality test using eosin nigrosin. It is a one-step staining technique. Nigrosin used to increase the contrast between the background and the sperm head. So nigrosin gives a background color. It can be assessed with eosin alone, because eosin is the stain which used to stain the sperms. Method: mix the sample well, remove 50 microliter aliquot of sample and mix with the equal volume of eosin nigrosin suspension in a test tube and wait for about 30 seconds. Make a smear on glass slide and allow it to dry in air. Examine immediately after drying or after mounting. Examine each slide with bright field optics at 1000x magnification and oil immersion. Count the number of stained, that is, if it is stained, it is a dead cell or unstained, that is, it is a vital cell. Evaluate 200 spermatozoa in each replicate for low sampling errors. Leaky neck membrane. Stain is limited to only a part of the neck region here, and rest of the head region is unstained. Here the stain is taken up only by a small portion of the neck region. Not a sign of cell death and total membrane disintegration is seen. These cells are counted as alive cells. Now in this slide you can see sperms. Stained cells are dead sperms. Unstained cells are vital or living cells. And staining a part of the counted as alive cells. Only a small portion is stained near the neck region. Those are counted as alive cells.